Here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts. In the ceremony today, we will witness the joining of Caleb Seth Johnston to Maureen Lily Porras in marriage. If there's anyone present who has just cause why this couple should not be united, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. Come together today so that God may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of Him in this community. Christ abundantly blesses your love He strengthens you so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity, and so forth, all in the presence of this community. Today, we have come together to witness the joining of two lives. For them, out of routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They met each other, they fell in love, and they're finalizing it with their wedding on this wonderful day. Romance is fun, but true love is something far more, and it is their desire to love each other for life that is what we are celebrating here today. I would like to start off by reading an excerpt from The Art of Marriage. A good marriage must be created. In life, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and to forget. It is giving each other the atmosphere in which each will grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner. Caleb and Maureen, I would ask that you always treat yourself and each other with respect and remind yourselves often what brought you here today. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do in every relationship at one point or another, focus on what still seems right between you, not the part that seems wrong. This way, when the clouds of trouble hide the sun in your lives and you lose sight of the moment, you can always remember that the sun is still there. And if each of you take responsibility for the quality of your life, it will be marked by an abundance of happiness. Caleb and Maureen have each prepared vows. Caleb and Maureen, please turn, face each other, and recite your vows.
Caleb, I would have never imagined that I could love someone the way that I love you. You're the most selfless, kind, generous person that I've ever met. I could never imagine my life without you. The very thought of that destroys me. Thank you for showing me the meaning of friendship and unconditional love. And for that, I pledge these vows. I promise to always put us first, to love you unconditionally, to always stand beside you and never abandon you, to always challenge you and push you to do great things, to help us grow and be the best individuals we can be, to be forever your best friend and love. Thank you for loving me.
Maureen, you are my heart and soul, my best friend. Nimeria Narana, and now my wife, and I could not imagine a more perfect person to spend the rest of my life with. You have inspired me to become the best version of myself, and for that, I pledge these vows. I promise to always communicate with you, to always show you loving affection, to always make sure that you always have chocolate. I promise to always be honest and truthful with you. I promise to protect our family, yes, including Cesar and Claudio, and any future pets we may adopt. And last, I promise to always make you smile. Maureen Lee, thank you for marrying me.
Dear friends, let us continue to love one another, for when love comes from God, anyone who loves is born of God and knows God. But anyone who does not love does not know God, for God is love. God showed how much he loved us by sending his only son into the world so that he might have eternal life through him. This is real love. It is not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son as a sacrifice to take away our sins. Dear friends, since God loved us that much, we surely ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love each other, God lives in us, and his love has been brought to full expression through us. Caleb Seth Johnson, do you take Maureen Lily Forrest to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only onto her forevermore?
I do.
Maureen Lily Forrest, do you take Caleb Seth Johnson to be your husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, protect him, forsaking all others and holding on to him forevermore?
I do.
Caleb and Maureen, let us celebrate this union. To celebrate this union, I call upon your best man and your maid of honor to help in the celebration. Would Colin and Nina please step forward, each lighting one of the side candles up here. Has the rings. The ring is a symbol of unbroken circle of love. Love freely, given that it has no beginning and no end, no giver and no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you of the vows you have taken here today. I, Caleb Seth Johnson. Take thee, Maureen Lily Porras, to be my wife.
Take thee, Maureen Lily Porras, to be my wife.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and in sorrow.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and in sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
I, Maureen Lily Porras.
I, Maureen Lily Porras.
Take thee, Caleb Seth Johnson, to be my husband.
Take thee, Caleb Seth Johnson, to be my husband.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and in sorrow.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and in sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
May these rings be blessed as a symbol of the affectionate unity. These two lives are now joined in one unbroken circle. Wherever they go, may they always return to one another in their togetherness. May these two find in each other the love for which all men and women yearn. May they grow to understand and have compassion. May the home which they establish together be such a place of sanctuary that many will find there a friend. May these rings on their fingers symbolize the touch of the spirit of love in their hearts. Bless their marriage, God, as they begin the journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead, for the road turns and bends, but help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing is perfect, and to look for the good in all things and all people, including themselves. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams, and fears, even though they may not always understand them. Help them to learn from each other and to help each other grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that no matter what happens to them, they will hold on to each other and know that things will always have a way of working out for the good. Help them to create for the future children a peaceful, stable home of love as a foundation on which they can build their lives. But most of all, God, help them light the torch of love as they now share, so that their loving example can be passed on the light of love to their children and to their children's children forever. To help your relationship work, it will take love. This is the core of your marriage and why you are here today. It will take trust to know that in your hearts, you truly want what is best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn and to grow together. It will take faith to go forward without knowing exactly what the future brings. And it will take commitment to hold true the journey you both have pledged here today. I would like to end by reading you one of my favorite Shakespearean sonnets. Sonnet 116 is about love in its most ideal form. Shakespeare praises the glories of lovers who have come to each other freely and enter into a relationship based on their understanding. Let me not the marriage of true minds admit impediments. Love is not love which alters when it alteration finds, or bends when the remover to remove. Oh no, it is an ever fixed mark that looks on the tempest and never shaken. It is a star to each wandering bark, whose worth unknown, although his height be taken. Love's not time's fool, through rosy lips and cheeks, within the spending sickle's compass comes. Love alters not with its brief hours or weeks, but bears it all out, even to the edge of doom. My dear friends and family, let us turn to God and pray that he will bless Caleb and Maureen, who have been united in true marriage today. Father, you have made the union of husband and wife so holy, as it symbolizes the marriage of two humans through Christ to God. Look with love upon Caleb and Maureen. Fill them both with love for each other, both honoring and respecting each other, and always seeing their love as a gift to be treasured. May the commitment which they are making be sacred, not only for today, but for the rest of their lives. We ask that this blessing for them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. By the authority vested in me by the state of Florida, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss each other. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Johnston.
We'll fix it.
Yeah, the cable was pressure.